Madania, and my research question is overpopulation. How has it changed America's environment and the overall health of Americans? I used the third and fourth stimulus materials to develop my question of how did overpopulation affect the environment to the point where it's affecting the health of Americans. The third stimulus material is a call to action towards eliminating climate change and hopefully involving the participation of both industrialized and developing countries, which is what the fourth stimulus material is about. The fourth stimulus material goes further into the urbanization of developing countries and how this urbanization influences the globe's climate, changing climate. The Earth's surface can only fit so many people, and the Earth's atmosphere can only handle so much pollution. If Americans made the connection between overpopulation, a worsening environment, and the worsening health of Americans, we could take the right steps to prevent the world and ourselves from collapsing. Believe it or not, America's atmosphere was actually worse 50 years ago than it is now. These are pictures from the first Earth Day back on April 22, 1970. During the late 1960s, an environmental crisis occurred as a series of environmental catastrophes transformed the American consciousness. Smog in New York City and Los Angeles, the Santa Barbara oil spill, and the Cuyahoga River fires all made headlines and frightened Americans. Paul Yurick's book, The Population Bomb, which was written in 1968, connected the dots and helped the public realize that the issues were all related. An exponentially growing population meant an increasing demand for limited resources, which led to an unwise decisions about resource use. In the late 1960s, the population of America was 205.1 million. As of 2017, the population was 325.7 million. The U.S. Census Bureau says that the United States is projected to grow by 78 million in the next four decades, from leaving the population at 404 million by 2060. However, some may argue that the population rate has actually decreased over the last 50 years. Vox, a credible news outlet that covers topics from politics to pop culture, says in a report written by Alex Press that the total fertility rate has gone down to 1.76 children per woman in 2017. This is well below the replacement rate, or the rate at which is needed to maintain a stable population of 2.1 children per woman. To put this in a larger perspective, the U.S. Census Bureau says that since 2010, the population has grown by 2.3 million people per year, and is expected to stay like this until 2030, when it will lower to 1.8 million people per year into 2040. Although this may be true for the natural population rate, this does not include the immigration rate, which is still rising and is expected to overtake the natural increase as the leading cause of population growth. In the fourth stimulus material, the urban transformation of the developing world explains partly why this has happened. Even though the material's main focus is on developing countries such as Asia and Africa, what is discussed can still be applied to the population status of America. According to the stimulus material, which was written back in 2008, says that it is projected that the population populations in more rural areas are expected to decline. This is because smaller cities are less well provided with basic services and do not have more job opportunities than cities do. With more people moving to bigger cities, which are more industrialized and thus already more polluted, there's more of a demand for the resources that emit pollution, such as transportation, power generation, and manufacturing, thus causing urban cities to become more concentrated with pollution. Ozone, according to the Global Climate Research Program, or the GCRP, is a compound usually found in the Earth's atmosphere that prevents harmful ultraviolet rays from reaching the Earth's surface. Ozone production is not only a result of vegetation and wildfires, but of motor vehicle transportation and power generation. The Environmental Protection Agency says that motor vehicle transportation accounts for 26% of emissions since 1990, and power generation accounts for 31% of this since the same year. The GCRP says that current levels of ground ozone have been estimated to be responsible for many cases of respiratory irritants. Or near the Earth's surface, ozone levels are very dangerous to the respiratory system, and it's responsible for tens of thousands of hospital and emergency room visits, school absences, and thousands of premature deaths. Overpopulation can be solved by the awareness of family planning. Raising awareness among people regarding family planning and informing more about serious after effects of overpopulation can help. A good way to let them know is about various safe sex techniques and contraceptive methods if available to avoid unwanted pregnancy. As for the air, some easy things you can do is reduce your consumption of energy and also use eco-friendly transportation methods such as public transport, biking, walking, or carpooling.
What information did you need that you were not able to find or locate? How did you go about trying to find that information?
Well, I actually had some difficulty with my solution, and especially about the overpopulation part of that solution. There wasn't very much on what you could do, because there were actually a lot of articles on how you couldn't stop overpopulation, how you can't just stop people from having babies, which kind of set me back from finding a realistic solution to overpopulation, especially with the immigration rate still rising and a lot of politics surrounding that. It's kind of hard to incorporate. It was kind of hard to incorporate that within my research.
Thank you. And second question. What advice would you have for other researchers who consider this topic?
I would say to put more time into it, or at least make sure you go into depth thoroughly. I feel like I did go into depth, but